Johnson's Wax Research Tower in Racine, Wisconsin, come work-saving waxes and polishes that are used around the world. And now the makers of Johnson's Wax present the exciting television game, The Name's the Same. Now, let's meet our Name's the Same family. First, representing the sterner side of the family, hard-hitting sportscaster Bill Stern. Representing the artistic side of our family, Joan Alexander. And that delightful skeleton in the family closet, Gene Rayburn. Overseeing them all, the head of our family, just off the boat from Europe, Robert Q. Lewis.
Thank you very much. Welcome to The Name's the Same. What is with that new introduction business? Lee, you're outdoing yourself. I'm real happy to be back after 2 weeks away, and I'd like to take this opportunity to say a big fat thank you so much to Mr. Brian Ahern for filling in and doing my job so beautifully while I was away. Thank you, Brian, and good luck tomorrow night when your new show, Escapade, opens here in New York. Well, tonight, once again, on The Name's the Same, you're going to meet people with very famous names. Names the same as celebrities, places, and things that you all know.
So, you're on the road again, missing another birthday party. And you're missing seeing your brand new granddaughter. There's got to be a way to connect. Introducing Quick Connect, the fastest, easiest way to connect with your loved ones on the web. Now, you never have to miss another special occasion. Quick Connect is as easy as 1, 2, 3. Just clip on, plug in, and load the software. You'll be online with family and friends in no time. Webcams used to be complicated and hard to set up. They rarely worked right out of the box, but Quick Connect is easy. Just insert the disc, plug in the camera, and you're ready to use any messaging service to connect instantly. It really is amazing. Dedicated video phones are hard to set up, and similar cameras can cost hundreds of dollars. Quick Connect even has a built-in microphone so college students can check in with their parents.
You'll have to ask your dad.
Working moms can see their children at home. Grandma can read to the grandchildren.
I see a red dinosaur. I see a green dinosaur.
Families can even connect with loved ones in the military.
My parents live across the country, so I never get to visit. But now with Quick Connect, I can see them anytime I want.
And we get to see her, too.
There's nothing like a face-to-face meeting when you're getting ready for a presentation. With Quick Connect, I can hook up with the home office and even show them concept sketches. It saves us a ton of time, travel, and money. We might even be a little bit under budget on that.
You can even use Quick Connect to make sure your pets are safe and sound. Now, on this special TV offer, get Quick Connect, the easy-to-use all-in-one webcam for just $29.95. Call right now and we'll send another Quick Connect free. That's right, that's two Quick Connects for the price of one. Don't get left behind in the information age. Get connected quickly with Quick Connect. Don't wait. Call now for rush delivery.
Call 1-800-824-6815 to take advantage of this special offer and receive two Quick Connect cams for just $29.95 plus shipping and handling. Call 1-800-824-6815.
All right, I think we're set to play The Names the Same. Let's meet our first guests with famous names.
Well, how do you do? You're pulling real close there.
Well, let's see now. My name is Lewis. Don't tell us yours, but where are you from, darling?
Richmond, Virginia.
Richmond, Virginia. You go to school down there, do you?
Yes.
Good. How old are you?
11.
11. And you, young man, where are you from?
New York.
New York City.
Yes.
And do you go to school here?
Yes.
How old are you?
9.
9 years old. You two want to go study?
No.
All right. Well, I just thought I'd help a little bit. Both of these young people have very famous names, and of course, these two names fit together. They fit together. And panel, of course, it's up to you to cross-examine these two people to find out what their famous names are. Before we do that, let's let our home audience see their famous names. All right, the rules have remained the same, if the introductions have not, while I've been away. 10 questions apiece. Each panelist who uses up his questions or fails to guess the right name must pay each contestant $25, right? All right, let's start with Joni. Joni Alexander.
Glad to have you back, Bob.
Thank you.
Are you two both living?
Yes.
You are?
Yes.
Are you... Are you married to each other?
No.
Are your names linked romantically with each other?
Romantically?
Mm-hmm. No.
You don't think so? All right.
No.
Oh, wait a minute. Are you both men?
Yeah.
You seem a little doubtful about both men, and you hesitated on alive, too. Oh, is it possible that one of you might possibly be a famous dummy?
Well, you're not in the sense you mean, Joan. No, one of them is not a famous dummy, no.
Are you performers?
No.
No.
Are you in politics?
No.
Right, together now. I'm getting nowhere. Thing going here. Together, let me hear no. One, two, three.
No.
Yeah, I didn't hear you. I didn't hear you. One, two, three.
No.
Well.
One, two, three.
You
I
have three questions. All right, Bill Stern, 10 questions.
Well, let me sum up what we've learned. You are living, you are men, you are not performers, and you are not in politics. Is this correct?
That's about right.
Has your pictures been in the papers in connection with any news stories of any kind?
Yes.
Yes, as a matter of fact. Mm-hmm.
Has one of you just been released from prison?
I have all the facts here. Let me take a... No, I don't think just released. Now, as a matter of fact, I don't believe either one of them has been in prison yet.
We asked if you were performers, and the answer was no. Are you, by any chance, connected with the industry in some behind-the-scenes way?
You mean show business?
That's correct.
Yeah, wouldn't you say yes?
Yes.
All right, you would all agree to that? All right.
You are behind the scenes. Would this connection with the entertainment world be other than movies and the stage?
Yes.
Would children like these performances?
Yes. Yes.
Well, you seem a little doubtful about that. I think children would enjoy the performances, yes.
Children would like these performances. You're behind the scenes. Would these performers that you work with, would they be mainly animals?
You mean wild animals?
Yes. Yes, I mean wild animals.
I don't think we would call them wild animals. No, Bill. No, you
I'll
have
pass.
Four questions. All right, Gene, you've got 10 questions.
Would it help us to know exactly what you do behind the scenes?
Would you think it would help him to know what you to if you were who you were supposed to be? Would it help, do you? Yes, I think it might.
Now, we've established that they're real people, that they're...
Well, there's some little doubt, but I think... Well, yes, they're real people.
I mean, Joan asked, are you living? And then the answer was yes, is our
Well, if you call that living. Yes, they're
Does Mr. Lewis know these... Does he know you? Is he acquainted with you?
We have never met before. We have
no, what I mean is, the people that
yes, they're... Yes, Bill, Regine, I do.
You do? Mm-hmm. Are they friends? Are you friends of Mr. Lewis's?
Do you mean socially?
Yes.
No.
No.
Yes, they are friends of mine. Yes.
They are.
Mm-hmm.
Is it anyone in the studio now or connected with this program?
You know the answer. Yes.
It is?
Yes.
Someone on the stage?
Yes.
But he's not a performer.
No.
No.
Me?
No.
Oh, you're no friend of mine.
Oh.
You have four questions, Gene.
Joni, is she one of them?
No, she is not.
I'm a performer.
Oh, yes. I pass.
All right, Joni, three questions.
Is it the producers of this show?
It is.
I want to know. Which one
All right.
Is
right, now, who's Goodson? Who's Goodson? Who's Goodson? This is Goodson, and this is Todman. And folks, would you like to, just for the heck of it, see our producers? They're over there. Let's bring them out here. Bill Todman and Mark Goodson of Goodson-Todman Productions. the money, you kids go over there. Johnson's Wax has a whole bunch of checks for you. And thanks very much for being on the Names of the Same.
Very good.
All right. Let's meet our next guest with a famous name. Well, let's go through the preliminaries, my dear. Where are you from?
Watchung, New Jersey.
Watchung, New Jersey. That is near Plainfield, mm-hmm. Is it not?
You see, I know the state of New Jersey. What do you do?
Housewife.
Good for you. Now, you've got a famous name. For submitting this name to us, we're sending $10 to Mrs. N. Johnson of Plainfield, New Jersey. Let's let our home audience see this lady's famous name. This is the part of the show I think I like best of all. This lady's name represents a thing. Miss X's name is a thing. Let's start off with Gene Rayburn. It's a thing.
A thing. Is this a thing that I might have in my home?
Yes.
Yes.
Is it decorative?
Oh, yes.
Would I frame it and hang it on the wall?
I don't think.
Well, you don't know him very well. No, I somehow doubt it, Gene.
Does it also have a useful purpose?
Oh, yes.
Yes, indeed.
It does. Is it portable? Would I take it outside?
Yes.
Sure,
I would.
You might just take it purely, yes.
Does it come in handy when it rains?
I would say it would come in very handy when it rains. Yes, indeed.
On a rainy day, when you bring this thing indoors, does it drip water all over the rug?
Well, no? Sure, if you brought it inside, it would drip all over the rug. Yes, yes.
Is it considered bad luck to hold one over your head inside a house?
That'd be bad luck. I don't think it's in the tradition of bad luck, though. I don't know.
Yeah, I don't either.
I pass. All right, Joni, 10 questions.
This thing you're referring to, might it be handier actually in cold weather than on a rainy day?
Well, yes, very definitely. Better, it would be more, yes.
Is it something that I might wear?
I doubt that very much. I don't think you would wear it. Do you, Mrs. X?
Well, she might.
Really? Well, I don't want to mislead her too much. I don't think you would actually wear this. Not you, Joan. No.
I see. Is it something that's more useful to a man on a cold day?
Now you're getting more to the point. Yes, it would be more useful to a man on a cold day. Yes.
Would you say that it's reasonably soft to the touch?
Yes, it is, as a matter of fact, yes.
Mm-hmm. Well, do men wear these around their necks, Tom
it's a good trick, I never thought. No, I don't think, I don't think you'd find it worn that
it's
way.
Not a muffler, then, or anything
no,
like that.
No.
Why, pal?
No. All right, Bill, 10 questions.
Bob, is this thing, whatever it is this living?
Very definitely living. Don't you be afraid. Just move in there and answer now.
Oh, sure. Is it a human being?
No.
Oh, yes. Sure.
It is a human being.
It is a human being.
Is it male?
No. Well, wait a minute. It could be.
It could be male or female?
It could be. I was thinking of it all along as being...
this a grown-up?
Preferably, but it doesn't have to be. It could be a young...
Is this a nickname for a girl?
In certain instances, don't you think?
Mm-hmm.
A doll?
Yeah. Oh, you mean a literal doll?
Yes.
No, I don't believe there's a doll called by this name, although I may be wrong.
But is this a term we apply to a specific type of girl?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Three questions, Bill.
Cute?
No.
I'll pass, Bill.
All right, Gene, two questions. This is a toughie.
Is it something like, when a girl passes, you say, a queen? Is that kind of the idea we're after?
No, I think it's a nickname of sorts, but I think you'd better try to find out its derivation on what the nickname is based.
I see. Now we've established that
it is human, either male or female, either young or old. And it is not only a nickname, but an actual description. And one more question is all I'm going
to
give you.
All right, I'll give it to Joan because she thinks
Johnny?
He knows it.
Has it something to do with a girl's physical characteristics?
Yes.
Has it anything to do with, from the neck up?
Yes.
Has it anything to do with the hair?
Yes. Two questions.
Color of hair?
Yes, one question.
A blonde?
No. I'm going to call time here, because I think this lady deserves all the money, but I think you would have gotten to it. The lady's name is A. Redhead. A. Redhead. You were very close. What does the A stand for?
Ada.
Ada Redhead. Well, Ada, you go on over, meet our panel. You got the full prize. One check from Bill, one from Joan, one from Jean. Thanks so much from Johnson's Wax for being with us tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, here is tonight's guest celebrity, one of the most beloved men in American music and one of the greatest human beings around today, Mr. Pops Paul Whiteman. Awful good to see you, Pops. I see you on television frequently. I hear that great music, and it's wonderful to have you sitting here.
Well, thank you. Thing.
Anything you want to talk about? You look
not
wonderful.
Not particularly. I feel good.
Yeah, you look good. That's
everybody
great.
Asked me if I've been dieting. Not exactly. I eat like a little pig instead of a big one.
Well, it seems to me that you have been taking off a little weight.
A light 60.
You look very handsome, my dear
thank
boy.
You,
we're going to be playing our guessing game with you in a couple of moments.
With the Memorial Day Marathon.
105.
All right, now, panel, it's time for you to go to work on Pops Whiteman over here. Before the show, we talked to Paul Whiteman. We asked him for a secret wish. And El Doctoro told us that his wish was something he would like to see happen, a certain event he would like to see happen. It's up to you to solve Paul Whiteman's sort of secret wish. But first, let's let our home audience see what it is Paul Whiteman would like to see happen. Would you open the curtain, please? Please? Thank you. All right, now this is going to be an interesting one. Let's start this with Bill Stern. Bill, you begin, please.
Paul, this thing that you would like to see happen, would you be involved in it?
I'm afraid so.
Would there be many other people involved in it?
Maybe.
Would it be both sexes?
Definitely not.
Be interesting, but not so.
Yeah.
Would it be only men?
Yes.
Would this be something that this group of men would need great courage and daring to do?
Maybe.
Yeah, I would take a... On my part, I would take it. Some guys might not need any courage to do it.
I'll pass.
All right, Bill. Gene, 10 questions.
Would it happen to all the men in America?
Could.
That would be part of the wish, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Would it not, Paul?
I think
yeah.
So.
Be fair.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever... Would every man that it happened to be happier after it happened?
That's looking in the future.
I don't really know how to answer that question, Gene. I think it'd be a pretty personal thing. Come see, come saw. Mm-hmm. As we say on the other side.
Yes, of course. Well, basically, this is a good event that you'd like to see happen, isn't it?
As opposed to bad, yes.
Yes, yes. It is. And would it make them richer?
Save a little money.
Yeah.
I didn't hear the answer.
It could save a little money. It wouldn't make them tremendously richer. It would save a little loot.
Uh-huh. Does it have anything to do with marriage?
Could. Might prevent it. Yeah.
Does it have anything to do with the men altering their physical appearance in any way?
No.
No.
By physical appearance, I want to help be sure we got this straight. By physical appearance, you mean a portion of the body.
Yes, I mean such as growing a beard or shaving your head or doing that.
Okay.
Well, then I pass.
All right, Joni, 10 questions.
Well, you sort of hesitated about that, Bob. Would it alter their physical appearance externally in any way?
Yes.
You mean it would alter the clothes they wear in some way?
Some extent. Halfway, anyway.
Well, thank you. Is it something to do with shorts?
Yeah, wait a minute. Whoa, yeah.
You wish men would wear shorts in the summertime?
No.
All the time?
All year round. I don't know, Paul. I don't know how it would look. What do you really think?
Well, I'll tell you what really let it on. One time I had a concert with the combined Philadelphia Orchestra and the Whiteman Band. And the deal I made was that if I went to Philadelphia and gave two concerts, there was only about 30 or 40 of us, then they'd bring the whole 125 to New York and we'd give a concert. So we did for a charity. And Ms. Whiteman joined me the day after we had the first rehearsal, and she brought my tails and didn't bring any pants. So I rustled around over to Philadelphia Club and got a pair of pants from a waiter that weighed 300 pounds. I did it. However, Ms. Whiteman got the bellboy at the Essex House to get on the train and bring them to me. But ever since that day, you know, I've had the biggest yen to give a concert at Carnegie. Give it half with the tails and half with the tails and shorts.
You know something? I'll be there. I don't want to see. Paul, go on over. Say hello to the kids. Thanks from Johnson's Wax for playing me. Now let's meet our next guest with a famous name. Next guest. Hi, darling. We have little or no time left. Where are you from?
Brooklyn, New York.
Brooklyn, New York. Move in, darling. And where do you go to school? I know you go to school around here, don't you?
Yes. I go to 202.
Good for you. We know you've got a famous name. For sending our name to us, we're sending $10 to Miss Elsie Slee of Brooklyn for, you know, your name. Let's let our home audience see this young lady's famous name. Famous name, curtain, please. Atta boy. They're goofing tonight. All right, my dear, let me see now. Let's start this off with Gene Rayburn. We haven't got much time. Gene,
okay. Miss X, are you living?
Yes.
Are you an American?
Yes.
Are you in the arts?
Mm-hmm.
Are you... You are?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Television?
No.
No? Cinema?
The lady would be best known, I think, for her efforts
in the motion picture.
Motion picture.
Currently popular?
Ever popular, but...
Mae Bush?
Thank you. You just won the prize. No, not Mae Bush, but...
No.
You have about 30 seconds to go.
Je passe.
All right, Joni.
Are you a leading lady?
Yes.
Do you also sing?
No.
Have you ever won an Academy Award?
No.
Are you...
Go on.
Are you noted for your great beauty?
Yes.
Are you married?
Yes.
To somebody famous?
Yes.
Well, I would say famous in his own field, in his own right. Yes. One more question, though, and I'm sorry, I can't...
Famous in baseball?
No, I'm sorry, I'm going to have to call time. There's just no more tonight. This young lady's name is Myrna Loy.
Oh.
Myrna, I'm going to ask you to go over there to meet our panelists and get three checks for $25 each from Bill and Joni and Jean, and thank you very much from Johnson's Wax for playing tonight.
The panel and I will be back in a moment, folks, to tell you how they did in about next week's show. But first...
Where do you go to find a great game of...
And visit learnpsoriasis.com.
I'd like to learn what it's like to like what I see in the mirror.
Right, you are, Gene. Thank you. Now let's have a little accounting. Bill Stern, will you make your report?
Bob, I'm sad and glad. Glad that you're back, but sad that I lost $100. Thank you and good night.
Johnny, how about you?
I lost $50, and I'm going to pay it off in lira, because that's what Bob brought us back. Good night, everybody.
Gene Rayburn, how about you?
Well, for the eighth consecutive week, I've lost, and I'm getting a complex about it. I don't mind losing the $100 here, but look at all it's costing me with a psychiatrist. Good night, Dr. Freud.
Good night, panel. You did very, very well. So long, folks, from the makers of Johnson's Wax. The panel and I will be looking forward to joining you again next week at the same time, when we'll be brought to you on The Name's the Same by C.A. Swanson and Son. Good night.
They're deep stacked.